Hello class, and welcome to Module 6, the Central Limit Theorem. This week we're going to be looking at a very important aspect of the Gaussian or normal distribution. The Central Limit Theorem is one of the most important results in statistics, so we're going to give it our full attention. All right, let's find out what it is even talking about. All right, the Central Limit Theorem is the main reason why the Gaussian distribution or normal distribution is so important to us. And here I'm going to try to state it pretty simply. Let's say you have a bunch of data, or say some random variable x. Okay, you can think of it as you have some population and you're going to be sampling from it, and every value is an observation of this random variable. So you have a sample x1, x2, x3, x4, whatever, all the way up to xn. So you have a sample, and it should be a random sample, and everything should be independent of each other from the sample. So it's a proper, good, random sample. All right, so here's the Central Limit Theorem. As the sample size n increases, the distribution of the sample mean, this is capital X bar, this is the random variable which models the mean of our sample, is going to get closer and closer. Its distribution is getting closer and closer to a normal distribution, with a mean equal to the population mean and a standard deviation equal to the population standard deviation divided by square root of n. So roughly speaking, no matter what your population looks like, the sample mean will be, we can use the normal distribution when modeling the sample mean or when calculating probability relating to the sample mean. That's what it says. So things tend to converge to a normal distribution. And this actually has to do with sample sums as well as sample means. And so this is actually indirectly why a lot of things in nature are normally distributed. As some value is a result of a random process which maybe accumulates day by day by day, say, for example, an elm tree in a forest, let's say you plant a bunch of sunflowers. Let's look at sunflowers instead. You plant like 100 sunflowers. Every day, depending on a lot of random factors, a sunflower is going to grow a little bit. And it's going to grow some amount, right? A little bit more, a little bit less, could be due to a lot of different factors. As it adds up day by day by day, you're getting the sum of a lot of random variables adding up. And what you should get in the end is a distribution of heights that is normally distributed, even though the height addition every day might not have anything to do with the normal distribution. The sum of a lot of little random bits, as long as the distribution doesn't really change, it's going to look like a normal distribution. Okay, so that's the idea. Central Limit Theorem is about sample means or about sample sums. This sigma with the little subscript x bar is called the standard error of the mean. That's a term you should know. So let's look at some other examples of Central Limit Theorem. Here's a funky old distribution. This is a very much not a normal distribution, right? You've got these two tails where all the probability is accumulated out at the extremes, and there is nothing right at the middle. That's a density curve, so to speak. So it's not a normal distribution. The mean is zero, and the standard deviation is 0.707. Okay, so imagine now that we start drawing samples from this distribution, and we calculate a sample mean. Okay, let's take a sample of size 5. 5 random variables from this distribution. Here are my numbers. We've got 0.35, negative 0.89, negative 0.94. Okay, so we get our 5 numbers, and the sample mean from this sample of size 5 is negative 0.502. Okay, that's what we got this time. Let's calculate a sample mean of many, many samples. So we're going to get a whole bunch of sample means, and then we're going to look at a histogram of the sample means. I did this, and here is what I got. I took 100 sample means and I put them into this. Actually, I think I did more than 100. I think I maybe did 500 sample means. And this is the distribution of sample means that I got. All right? It looks nothing like the population that I was sampling from, right? It looks nothing like that. Its mean is still in this in around zero. And if we calculate the standard deviation of this, okay, well, here's what the Central Limit Theorem would predict. It says, okay, the mean of our sample means, the average value of sample means that we could get, it should be close to zero, should be zero. And the standard deviation of sample means, the standard error, is going to be 0.31618. That's what the Central Limit Theorem would predict. Now we from our data, I calculated the sample mean of these sample means, and it is negative 0.006. That's very, very close to zero. And it's the standard deviation from this sample is 0.317, which is, again, very, very close to 0.31618. So this is the Central Limit Theorem in action. Now, it also looks a lot more like a normal distribution, right? And the Central Limit Theorem also says, as we increase our sample size, we should see the normal curve emerging even more strongly. And let's do that. So a sample size of 10, we do see even more of a normal distribution emerge. So it only takes a sample size of 10 to see this really nice shape come out from our sample mean distribution. Again, the Central Limit Theorem would predict a mean of this distribution would be zero and the standard error of 0.22357. And I calculated a mean of negative 0.011 and a standard deviation of 0.223. Very, very close to what I would expect from the Central Limit Theorem. Okay, so that's really nice. This is just what I would expect to see. So notice as the central limit theorem is telling us that the standard error is going to get smaller and smaller as my sample size increases because I'm dividing by the square root of n. So as I get a bigger and bigger sample size, I expect my sample mean to be closer to the population mean. It should be close to the population mean, and the amount that it varies from that is going to get smaller and smaller as my sample size gets bigger. And of course, this makes sense because how could you get a sample mean that's vastly different from the population mean? You know, that's really a lot bigger. Well, the only way that would happen is if a lot of the individuals in your sample are extremely, you know, extremely different from the population mean. Say like extremely bigger or have a value that's much, much bigger. That might happen for a small sample. You know, if I'm looking at people's heights and I go and interview 10 or 5 random people, maybe I just happen to get 5 really tall people. Okay, that could happen with 5 people, sure. But what if I have a sample size of 1,000? Is it likely that I'm going to get 1,000 really, really tall people? Probably not. Right, I'm going to get a few tall people, but I'm going to get some short people too, and I'm going to get people who are in the middle. More often than not, people are going to be closer to the mean. As you get a big sample size, it's going to be harder and harder to get so many extreme individuals that it's going to sway my sample mean so far to the left or to the right. So the Central Limit Theorem captures that idea in this idea of the standard error decreasing as the sample size gets bigger. All right, now the Central Limit Theorem applies to sums as well. Like I said before, if you have a random variable x, it could have a known or an unknown distribution. As we start drawing samples and we start adding up our random variables, the sample sum uses this Greek capital sigma, looks kind of like a zigzaggy E. The sample sum is also going to be normally distributed, or approximately normally distributed, as the sample size increases, and it's going to have a mean of n times the population mean. And the standard error of the sum is going to be square root of n times the standard deviation of the population. So this standard deviation is going to grow at a rate of square root of n, square root of the sample size. Okay, so the sample sum is going to get bigger and bigger and get bigger, but that's what you would expect to see. And the standard deviation is going to grow at this rate. So here's an example. We have a fish. Okay, so a fish is going to grow by a random length x from a uniform distribution from 0 to 0.1 millimeters every day. So I'm interested, okay, after 100 days, how long or how much would I expect the growth of the fish to be? Okay, so now I'm accumulating random variables that are from a uniform distribution, and I want to see, well, what's the possibility for the growth? I'm going to simulate this. Okay. Now, you should know, a uniform distribution, we talked about it a couple weeks ago. If it ranges from 0 to 0.1, the mean is 0.5. And the standard deviation, there's a formula for it, 0.028868. The Central Limit Theorem for sums says the total growth, which is the sum of the daily growth, should follow a normal distribution, approximately, with a mean of 0.05 times 100, which is 5 millimeters. And the standard deviation is going to be 0.028868. That's the square root of 100, that's 10, times the standard deviation of a single day. Okay, that's what I would expect to see. Let's see what I just did a simulation of this. I simulated 500 samples of size 100 from a uniform distribution, and this is what I got. The mean of my sample sums is 5.004, which is almost exactly what I was expecting. And the standard deviation of these sample sums is 0.295, which is, again, almost exactly what I was expecting. So you can see for sample means and for sample sums, the Central Limit Theorem is going to tell us that we are going to see the normal distribution is going to be useful for modeling these. Now, this doesn't mean that if you do a sample of a 500 and then you plot a histogram of that sample, you're going to see a normal distribution. That's not going to happen. What's going to happen is if you take a big sample and then calculate the mean or the sum of that sample, and then if you were to do a bunch of make a histogram of a lot of sample sums or a lot of sample means, that's where you see the normal distribution emerge. So the Central Limit Theorem doesn't say as you sample from a population, the bigger the sample size, the more the sample is going to look like a normal distribution. That's not what it says. It's talking about the sample mean or the sample sum.